डी ब्रॉगलीज हाइपोथेसिस इज कंसर्न विद द देर इज ए वेव प्रॉपर्टीज एज वेल एज पार्टिकुलेट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑल्सो टू द मैटर व्हेन एवर इट इज इन ए मोशन. व्हाट हैपन्स एज पर द प्लैंक्स क्वांटम थ्योरी व्हेन एवर लाइट रेडिएशंस आर ट्रांसमिटिंग फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस देन दैट लाइट रेडिएशंस आर प्रोपोगेटिंग और ट्रांसमिटिंग फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पार्टिकल्स आर द दैट पार्टिकल्स आर कॉल्ड क्वांटम आर द फोटॉन. दिस इज रिगार्डिंग द लाइट रेडिएशंस ओनली. Means as per the Planck's quantum theory or photon theory, it is made clear that light radiations are transmitting in the form of energy particles or the energy packets. That energy packets are called light photons or the quantum, and they possess wave properties as well as the particulate properties. This is related to the light radiations only. But later on, in 1924, Louis de Broglie had predicted that it is not better to keep only in the limit of light radiations, for the light radiations only. This case of the wave properties as well as the particle properties are also applicable for the matter also whenever it is in a motion. Means what? Whenever any matter as like the electron, atoms, whenever they are in under motion, they also possess the waves as well as they are consisting or showing the properties of particles also. And his hypothesis, he had given that hypothesis on the basis of Planck's quantum theory. And the Einstein's theory of relativity. And he had given the relationship between the momentum of a particle or matter which is under motion with the wavelength lambda associated with it. He had put one equation which is based on the Planck's quantum theory and Einstein's theory of relativity. As per the Planck's quantum theory, E is equal to h nu, and as per the Einstein's theory of mass and energy relativity, E is equal to mc square. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. This is as per the Planck's quantum theory, and this is as per the Einstein's theory of relativity. Then equating equation 1 and 2, mc square is equal to h nu. Mc square is equal to h nu, but nu is equal to c by lambda. So we can replace the value of nu here, h into c by lambda. Then by cancelling one c from here and this c, only remaining the m into c is equal to h upon lambda. M is the mass of a particle which is under motion, and c is its velocity. So we can write this equation in this way. Mass into velocity is equal to h upon lambda is the wavelength. So mass and velocity is nothing but the momentum p and h upon wavelength. So the momentum p is inversely proportional with the wavelength of that particle which is under motion. Means whenever any matter as like the electron or the atoms, whenever they are in a motion, they possess the waves as well as the particular properties also. And he had given a relationship between the wavelength lambda and momentum associated with that particle whenever it is under motion. And he had given the equation that a momentum of a particle which is under motion is inversely proportional with the wavelength lambda. Means what? Whenever the momentum is more, the wavelength is low. And this relationship between the momentum and the wavelength lambda of a particle which is under motion, this is more applicable for the small bodies. We are considering first, we are trying to apply this hypothesis to find out the wavelength lambda whenever by considering a larger body as like 100 gram of the stone or any iron piece which is under motion having the velocity 100,000 centimeter per second. In that case, we are trying to find out the wavelength lambda. Lambda is equal to, from this equation we can write the equation, lambda is equal to h upon mc. So by putting the value of h, that is the Planck's constant, 6.6256 into 10 to the power minus 27, this is the value of h, this one, and by putting the value of mass of that stone is 100 gram, so by putting the 100 gram into c is the velocity of the given stone, that is 1000 centimeter per second. By calculating it, we are getting this much value, that is 6.6256 into 10 to the power 34 minus 32 centimeter. 6.6256 into 10 to the power minus 32 centimeter. This is the wavelength for a larger body as like stone having the mass 100 gram. Then now we are trying to apply the same equation for a body which is lighter one as like the electron. Mass of electron is 9.1091 into 10 to the power minus 28 gram, and the velocity of electron whenever it is in motion in the atomic structure, its velocity is 2.188 into 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter per second. For the electron like smaller body and for the given value, by putting these values in the given equation, we can calculate the wavelength lambda. By putting the value of h, 6.6256 into 10 to the power minus 27 upon m, mass of the electron, that is 9.1091 into 10 to the power minus 28 into the velocity of the electron, that is 2.1888 into 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter. After calculating, we are getting this much, this value, that is 3.32 into 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter. In this case, this value is a larger one than that of this value. Means here 10 raised to minus 32, here 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter only. And hence this value is a larger one. Means the wavelength in case of the lighter or the smaller bodies as like electron, that wavelength is, that is de Broglie's wavelength is considerable, or it is taken under consideration. But for the larger bodies as with 100 gram of stone, the value of wavelength lambda is very small one. And hence this hypothesis is more applicable for the smaller bodies as like the electron. This is the de Broglie's equation. De Broglie's equation is giving the relationship between the momentum and the wavelength associated with the particle which is under motion. And he proved that whenever the any particulate matter or matter of a particle like, that particle under motion must or possesses the properties of waves as well as particulate properties. This is the de Broglie's equation. Thank you.